Yes, hi everyone, welcome to this IFR tutorial. This video will be about a GPS approach that has already been set up via the GPS unit, and basically we will fly that approach right now. Okay, so we are currently located next to the Kilo Echo Delta Delta Echo Delta Airport, which is the D-Land Airport, and we will be flying the RNAV Approach runway 07 left into the Daytona Airport, which is right here. For those of you who have watched my other video, we have set it up via procedures, activate vectors to final, press enter, and then you will have that magenta line. Four leg is our final approach fix, and we will be flying that right now. If you hand fly it, you can do that, of course. I will have the autopilot flight, and in order to do that, of course, you have to activate the autopilot. Use the altitude if you like that. If not, you have to press the APR button on your autopilot in the Cessna 172. So, autopilot, APR, and then what you will see is here will indicate you your distance towards that course. Okay, currently flying 0224 magnetic heading. Okay, and our desired track is 071 magnetic. That's pretty much our final approach course. We are about 4 miles away from our final approach fix, which is folic intersection right here, and we are about 1.6 nautical miles away from our desired final approach course, which is to the left, as you can see by that dot. Now our ground speed is around 97 knots, and we can decelerate a little bit. Here we have an APR, which indicates our approach mode from our autopilot. Okay, our next waypoint is folic intersection. Again, our current track is 032 033. Again, distance currently to folic intersection is 3 nautical miles left, and until we get there we will fly about one more minute. ETE is estimate time and route. Yes. So we have a message. Message is flashing. So if we press message, it just tells us that we have airspace ahead. But we know that it's just Charlie airspace. Okay. Ground speed is currently decreasing as I have decreased the power setting. Now here we have the nav, and if we use the cursor, that was the wrong one. That was the big cursor. If we use the small cursor, we can have a different look or top-down view of that approach, and you can of course zoom it in and see where we at. If we turn it counterclockwise, it will give us our other actual setting. And now you will also see that we can call that our digital CDI is traveling towards the center. Okay, so we are another 2 nautical miles away from folic intersection. Again, the leg that we are currently flying is magenta, and as soon as we pass our waypoint folic and enter our final approach leg, this leg will also switch from white to magenta. Okay, so the current path that we are flying as usual is magenta. So now we have intercepted more or less the final approach course, and again, the autopilot is flying it at the moment. So if you use your GPS, what you have to make sure, if you fly in an RNAV, there is a button just on top of your NAV1 OBS instrument, usually depending on your aircraft configuration setup of the instrument. You need to make sure that it is switched from NAV to GPS mode in order for your airplane to follow it properly. So here we go, we're almost there. It doesn't give you decimal numbers, so just full nautical miles. Here we go. We are currently on the way from Folic to runway 07 left. It has turned to magenta. 5 nautical miles left in about 4 minutes that we're supposed to be en route. So we can basically start our final approach towards the runway at this point. Yes, that's pretty much how you fly an RNAV approach. Remember, as it's a non-precision approach, so you will have an MDA to follow, or a step down fix depending. Make sure that you have activated your approach, and be careful that there is no RAME showing up, but of course you will see that. And that's pretty much it about GPS approaches. Just have to monitor it and make sure that everything is the way it should be. Okay, and again, here we have our waypoint. Next waypoint it would be the runway. And we have our desired track here, 071. That's also what we're currently flying. ETA estimated time of arrival is 21:33 local. Okay. And we're about 0.0 nautical miles to the right of, to the left of our course, so that's pretty much centered. You can say, again, message is flashing near airspace less than 2 nautical miles. That's not relevant right now. Estimated time on route is 0.01 minutes. Okay. So we'll fly that leg until we have passed the missed approach point, basically, and then you will see that the last approach, sorry, the last leg, or the missed approach procedure, like which you can see as dashes, will also turn to magenta. You wouldn't do that doing real flying. I just do it to accelerate a little bit and save some time, increase the speed, so you will have an idea of how it looks like when you pass the final approach fix. I'm sorry, the missed approach point. Sorry about that. Here we go, it switched to 340. You can see it right here, it has switched. And the next switch should be from 340 to our missed approach procedure, which is at 12 nautical miles distance. That will take just a little bit. Here we go. That's our missed approach path. Okay, if we zoom that out, you can see here straight to Gilney, whatever you'd like to call that, and then in hold, and you will see that it has also switched right here. 11 nautical miles left, and you basically just follow the procedure from now on, and of course talk to ATC. Okay, I hope that this was helpful, and yes, have fun flying, and see you next time. Thanks for watching.